Dear students and parents, welcome to the Test Prep Card channel once again. This is Pranay. As you know that in this video, we are going to talk about the top 20 engineering colleges in India, which are private in nature. Of course, we are focusing only on the private engineering colleges and not on the government engineering colleges. So in this video, we are going to talk about the colleges, tentative fee that you need to give, if they have an NRI quota or not, the probable eligibility, more or less the eligibility criteria will be same. I will also explain that to you by the end of the video. And the courses that these universities are offering to you. Okay, so let's start the video and let's just go to the list of colleges one by one. So as we have discussed about the top private engineering colleges in India, I have on my screen, as you can see right now, I have BMS College of Engineering from Bangalore, which is running in over here. What I did is I have started accumulating about the colleges from 10th to 1, from rank 10 to rank 1. Rank 11 to 20, I have given the link in the description because it's more about the details. You can click on the link in the description and you can get it again. Let's come to the 10th one, okay? That is BMS College of Engineering. This college is situated in Bangalore and holds a very good reputation. To get into this college, you need to give COMDEC as an entrance examination, and JE main marks are also getting considered here. In this college, you have a NRI quota also, but of course, as you know, for the NRI's fee, you need to pay a little higher because that's more like a management quota, and you need to pay maybe twice the fee of a normal Indian student. So that's about the BMS College of Engineering. Okay, it's in Bangalore. There are many colleges in Bangalore, approximately 110 colleges. So this is the 10th college. Let's come to the 9th college, private engineering college, 9th ranking, which is Sardar Patel Institute of Technology. Now, Sardar Patel College of Engineering, this basically is situated in Mumbai. Okay, as you can see here, it says Autonomous Institute affiliated to Mumbai University. To get into this college, from an entrance examination point of view, you need to write MHCET, okay? That MHCET score will help you in getting into this college. Roughly the fee that you need to pay in order to get into Sardar Patel College of Engineering is around 5 to 6 lakhs rupee. This is the fee that I'm telling you for from an Indian student point of view. But as far as the NRI quota is concerned, I'm not pretty much sure if they have it because I tried searching on the net, but I couldn't find much information about it. But I'm pretty much sure if they are having NRI quota, it'll be twice or thrice the fee which a normal Indian students they are having. And for the NRI students, I've already told you that you have much better possibilities in terms of DASA and CAWG. So just go through the ebook that we have created from the link in the description. That will help you immensely. Okay, so that was about Sardar Patel Institute of Technology, Mumbai. MHCET is the examination. Coming down to the 7th. 7th is Manipal Institute of Technology. Okay, to get this is also one of the renowned private engineering colleges in India, and they are having various courses from BTech to MTech to PhD. You have n number of courses available here, and they have medical courses also available with them. So as far as this is concerned, if you talk about the entrance examination, the only examination that you need to give to get into this college is MUOET. Okay, which is the regional entrance examination test for Manipal. But now considering Manipal is also one of the, I would say it's in terms of the fee, it's one of the costly institution to get into, because even if you are going through a merit over here, you will have to shell out somewhere around 12 to 14 lakh rupees for a 4-year degree. And of course, they have a NRI quota with them. Here you need to pay roughly 22 to maybe 30 lakh rupees. So that's a wide difference, but yeah, the management fee is a little higher. Okay, but yeah, the college is good. It's known nationwide. Coming back to the sixth college, over here, it's Ramaya Institute, MS Ramaya Institute of Technology, again based out of Bangalore. As I told you that Bangalore is having approximately 110 engineering colleges, being the IT hub. They also attract many engineering aspirants. To get into MS Ramaya Institute of Technology, you basically need to again write the regional engineering entrance examination for Bangalore, which is COMDEC, and they also accept KEAM score, which is the regional entrance test for Kerala. Apart from that, if you had written JEE Main earlier, you can also present your JEE Main score. So this is it about this college. Okay, let's go back to the next college, the fifth one. The fifth college over here, it says about the Thapar Institute of Engineering and Technology. Okay, it is a deemed university and it is based out of Patiala, Punjab. To get into this college, you need to have, or you need to present your JEE main score. As you can see that it's ranked first in private engineering institutions, but as far as the NRIF for rankings are concerned, Thapar University is coming at the sixth place. And the fee which you need to pay in order to get into this college is roughly around 6 to 7 lakh rupees for a complete 4-year BTech degree. Okay, and again for NRI students, this is going to be a pretty much higher. Okay, if you are planning from that point of view or from the management quota point of view. Otherwise, for you guys, the best thing to get into is start practicing from your DASA point of view, from your CAWG point of view. Get a good JEE score, and you are eligible for the most like 56 or 56 centrally funded institutions here in India, which are a very renowned one. And you get a scholarship also in terms of CIWG. CIWG is just only relevant for the NRI students from the Middle East. Okay, so this is it. Let me go to the fifth college. Now we are talking about the SRM college. Okay, SRM University. SRM University is based out of Chennai, and the entrance test that they require to get into this college is basically SRM triple E. Okay, and to get into SRM University, this is also, in terms of the, compared to the other colleges, the fee is little higher in SRM University. It's roughly around 12 to 14 lakh rupees per annum for Indian students, and of course they have management quota. Plus, if you have JEE main score, they accept that. From 2020, I think they started accepting it. So this is the fifth best engineering college, which is private in nature. Coming to the fourth college, which is RV College of Engineering, based out of Bangalore. I tried opening up their website, couldn't open it. They are having some issue. So engineering college websites are also not running up sometimes. So RV College of Engineering, again, since it belongs to Bangalore, they accept KEAM and they accept COMDEC, COMEDK, Regional State Engineering Entrance Test. Based on that, you can easily get admission into RV College of Engineering in BTech. And the good part is the fee is very affordable. It is because it's run by a trust based out of Bangalore, which is a not-for-profit. And if you're a regular student, you can easily get admission into RV College of Engineering for 4 to 5 lakh rupees for a 4-year degree. But just in case, if you plan to get a direct admission, you need to shell out a little more. Shelling out a little more means you need to give a draft to RV College somewhere around 25 to 30 lakh rupees as a donation, if I'm not wrong. Then the normal fee will be applicable. So roughly you can say 30 lakh plus for NRI students. For Indian students, it's going to be 4 to 5 lakh rupees. Okay, so that's about the RV College of Engineering, very renowned one in Bangalore. Coming to the third one, Birla Institute of Technology, MIRSA, based out of Ranchi state. Okay, based out of Ranchi. Now, Birla Institute of Technology, they are not conducting any of the separate entrance examination for this institute, but they will accept JEE main score. JEE main is a universal score because it's a nationwide entrance examination conducted by NTA. So most of the private universities accept that. Okay. So for that, you just need to have a clear-cut JEE main score, and as soon as you have that, based on your score and merit, you can apply into BITS MIRSA. Of course, now, yeah, the point over here is in terms of the fee is little higher because this will go somewhere from 13 to 14 lakh to 15 lakh rupees for a four-year degree. And you have a NRI or a direct admission option in Birla Institute of Technology, MIRSA also. So this is the third one. The second one, this is the another good institute known by everybody and holds a very good reputation, which is a VIT, Vellore Institute of Technology, based out of Vellore, Tamil Nadu. Vellore Institute of Technology, VIT, they conduct their own entrance examination called VIT Triple E. Okay, and as far as the fee is concerned, you have to shell out around 6 to 7 lakh rupees. I think one of the pop-up was just coming up here showing about the NRIs. I think if I can simply click on it and I can show you that. Okay, it's not coming up anymore. Anyway, so for VIT, they have a NRI quota. For entrance examination, they will take VIT Triple E, and this is the second best institute in India in terms of private engineering colleges, holds many awards in their names and accreditations. So this is about the VIT. Okay, here it's coming on the top. It says NRI and foreign applications over here. You'll be if you're the NRI student, you'll be able to find much more information over here on this side, on the right hand side, if my cursor is not visible to you. Now the best and the first private engineering college in India ranked first, it's BITS Pilani. Okay, now BITS Pilani is based out of Pilani, which is in Rajasthan. BITS Pilani is they conduct their own entrance examination called BITSAT. Okay, it's more on the lines of the SAT examination, which is a scholastic aptitude test. To get into BITS Pilani, you simply need to write BITS SAT, and based on their marks, you can simply get admission into BITS Pilani branch, because BITS are having 3-4 institutes separately. One is like in Dubai, Goa, and Hyderabad. If you are an NRI student based out of UAE, if you're thinking for Dubai, I won't recommend you to do it from there because it's very, very expensive. Plus, whatever you get out of it, it's not worthwhile. It's better to get, it's better to try for BITSAT and get into a BITS Pilani because they hold a very good reputation and is renowned also. So the fee that you need to pay in BITS Pilani is approximately 9 to 10 lakh rupees for a four-year degree. And there is no NRI quota which I could found. Okay, so this is it about the top best engineering colleges in India. These are the top 10 from 11 to 10. I have given the link in the description along with the details which I have spoken to you so far. You'll be able to find that in that respective link. So this is it. I hope you must have got some information out of it. You must be having many of questions with you. If you have those questions with you, do write it to me at info@testprepka.com related to anything, related to cutoff, fee, eligibility, quota, be it anything. You can just simply write it to us and we'll be able to provide you with the details. And yeah, do mention your contact number as well in the email, because sometimes it gets it really becomes difficult to get in touch with the audiences. Okay, so this is it. So thanks for watching.